When a sovereign God enters your presence, hallelujah, it should propel you to your feet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As we commit today to lift up a standard, hallelujah, a standard of worship, God, so that the power of God, hallelujah, that blood power, hallelujah, that bought my life and bought your life, hallelujah, can just reside amongst us, God, hallelujah. When we call down the blood of Christ, we call down power, hallelujah. We call down authority, hallelujah. So we stand today in our rightful place, hallelujah. Hallelujah, no more enemy tread, hallelujah. Yeah. No more body bent, hallelujah. No more suffering and violent, God, and not taking it by force, hallelujah. We stand today in the authority that our great God gave us, hallelujah. And we release his power, hallelujah, over this sanctuary, even right now, hallelujah. We release his glory, hallelujah, his all-consuming glory, hallelujah. We break the yoke of the enemy, hallelujah, right now, hallelujah, over this sanctuary, over his people, hallelujah. And we declare that we stand, God, hallelujah. We stand firm, God, hallelujah. No more tossed and turned by the enemy, God, hallelujah. But feet planted, hallelujah, in the authority that is ours through Christ Jesus, through the blood of the Lamb, hallelujah. So we release, God, power, hallelujah. Your power, your anointing, God, your sovereignty, your grace, your glory, hallelujah. We release that over this service, God. We pull in, God, with the one purpose, God. Unity, clarity, hallelujah, to release your power, hallelujah. This is your call to worship, hallelujah.
Good morning, Kingdom Grace Fellowship. Please turn with me to Psalms 98 for our scripture this morning. And it says, sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm have worked salvation for him. The Lord has made his salvation known and revealed his righteousness to the nations. He has remembered his love and his faithfulness to Israel. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our God. Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Burst into jubilant song with music. Make music to the Lord with the harp and the sound of singing, with trumpets and the blast of the ram's horn. Shout for joy before the Lord the King. Let the sea resound and everything in it, the world and all who live in it. Let the rivers clap their hands. Let the mountains sing together for joy. Let them sing before the Lord, for he has come to judge the earth. He will judge the world in righteousness and the people with equity. The Lord's word is already blessed. Amen.
Again, good morning, Kingdom Grace. Good morning. It's a blessing to be here this morning. When Overseer informed me that I was going to be doing a prayer, I said, no problem. I pray my wife to sleep every night. While I'm praying, she's taking her shower. She's doing her hair. She's getting her clothes ready for the next day. Her lunch. She's in the bed, sleep, and I'm still praying. But you know, yesterday I learned a couple of things. God dropped it in my spirit last night because I went to sleep and I woke up about 2:53. I said, I got to pray this morning. I don't know if I can do that because I'm used to praying at home. You know, it's like those people that can sing in the shower. Well, that's me. But But God said, you know what? It's not the length of the prayer. It's the sincerity in the prayer. So I might not pray 5 or 10 or 15 minutes. It might be 2 minutes.
That's fine.
But it's going to be an honest, sincere prayer. The second thing he dropped in my spirit was that during the intercessor, I've learned that we're all intercessors. I intercess every night that I pray for my family, for my wife, even for myself. So I want all of you to know that today we all gonna pray. And we all gonna intercess for our family, our friends, our co-workers, those folks that get on our last nerve. With that being said, Heavenly Father, thank you. Thank you for allowing us to come together. Thank you for allowing us to see another day. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for those haters out there that said we couldn't make it, but we pressed on. And look at where we're at today, Heavenly Father, and the best is yet to come. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for our families. Thank you for those children that we pray for every night. Thank you for those family members that we know need to be with you, God, but because we're interceding, we know it's all going to be okay. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Bless our overseer, her family. Thank you. Bless the Kingdom Grace family. These and all blessings we ask in your name and your Son, Jesus the Christ. Amen.
Hallelujah. How many of we serve an awesome God? I mean, he's an awesome God. So we give him praise today. We give him glory today. We give him honor today for being such an awesome, wonderful Savior. Amen. Come on, put your hands together. Your voice and say, Lord.
Love.
if it wasn't for your love. I don't know. Hold on, before we go further, think about this song, how we're singing unto the Lord, how good he is. And I like that part, it says, if it wasn't for your love, if it wasn't for your grace, I don't know where I'd be. See, I have a good ideal where I might have been. But because of his love, because of his grace towards me, oh God, think about the fact that we're here today. See, we weren't always at church on a Sunday morning, hands lifted up, giving God the praise, giving God the glory, giving God the honor. So I'm grateful today for what he's doing in my life. Now, I know some of y'all may get tired of hearing the testimony about where God has brought me from. But see, if you notice, I have on a new suit today. Listen, as I was getting dressed this morning, I was giving God the glory. Because see, there was a time that every dime that I had would have went to the crack man. Oh, God. And see, the mere fact that I could go to the store and buy a suit, he didn't get this one. Hallelujah. And so when I think about his goodness and I think about his grace, I just say, Lord, you're awesome. Hallelujah. Say, Lord. Hallelujah. I think about his grace. Say, Lord.
Lord, you are awesome.
Hallelujah. Say, Lord.
Lord,
you are awesome. If it wasn't for your love,
if it wasn't for your grace,
I don't know.
I
could have been dead, sleeping in my grave, if it wasn't for your love. If it wasn't for your grace,
I don't know.
Come on, put your hands together. Hallelujah. We give God the praise. We give God the glory. We give God the honor because he's awesome. Come on, say, you are awesome. Yes.
You are awesome.
You are awesome.
You are awesome,
God.
You are awesome.
Lord, you're awesome. You're awesome in this place. You're awesome in my life.
You are awesome.
You're awesome on my job.
You are awesome.
You're awesome in my home.
You are awesome.
You're awesome in my car.
You are awesome.
You're awesome in my mind.
You are awesome.
You're awesome in my spirit.
You are awesome.
Come on, take it up higher.
You are awesome.
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 You are awesome, God.
You are awesome.
You're an awesome God.
You are awesome.
You are healer.
You are awesome.
You're a deliverer.
You are awesome.
You're a way maker.
You are awesome.
You're my peace.
You are awesome.
You're my strength. You're my hope for the day.
You are awesome.
You're my joy.
You are awesome.
You're my peace.
You are awesome.
You're the lover of my soul.
You are awesome.
You're the keeper of my soul.
You are awesome.
We love you today.
You are awesome.
God, you're awesome.
You are awesome.
You are awesome, God.
You are awesome.
You're an awesome God.
You are awesome.
You're an awesome God. My God,
is an awesome God.
From heaven above,
with wisdom, power, and love.
The awesome God.
Our God
is the awesome God.
From heaven,
the power and love. Say it again.
Our God is the awesome God.
From heaven above,
with wisdom.
Come on,
you are awesome.
You are awesome, God.
You are awesome.
You're an awesome God.
You are awesome.
You're an awesome God.
You
Say it again. Our God.
Our God is the awesome God.
He reigns. Reign, Jesus. Reign, Jesus, reign. The awesome God. Our God.
Our God is the awesome God. He reigns.
From heaven above. You're awesome.
You are awesome.
You're awesome.
You are awesome.
You're awesome, God.
You are awesome.
You're awesome, God.
You are awesome.
You're awesome in here.
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 You are awesome.
God, you're awesome.
You're awesome.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
With wisdom, power. Come on, slow that down just a little bit. Our God.
Our God is the awesome God. He reigns.
From heaven above.
With wisdom. Some power and love. Our God is an awesome God.
Our God. He is the awesome God, because there's none other than him. From heaven above. Hallelujah.
Our God.
He reigns. Reign, Jesus. In here. Wisdom, power, and love. Our God is the awesome God. Our God. The awesome God.
The awesome God, he reigns.
Reign, Jesus, reign in here.
With some power and love, our God.
It's the awesome. One more time, our God. There's no God like Jehovah. No God like Jehovah. No God like Jehovah. No God like Jehovah.
Our God.
My God is awesome. Awesome in here. Mighty to save. Mighty to heal. Mighty to deliver. He's an awesome God. That's why I say my God is awesome. He can move mountains. Keeps me in the valley. And then he hides me. From the rain. Oh God. You know the Bible says that it rains on the just as well as the unjust. But he'll keep you in the rain.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Come on, praise team. Let's say, my God is awesome.
My God is awesome.
He can move mountains.
He can move mountains.
Keeps me in the valley. Hides me from the rain. My God is awesome. He heals me when I'm broken. Strength where I've been weak. Forever he will reign. Come on, say it again from the top. My God is awesome. He can move mountains. Keeps me in the valley. And then he hides me from the rain.
My God is awesome.
He heals me when I'm broken. Strength where I've been weak. Forever he will reign. Come on and say, my God is awesome.
Awesome.
Yeah, God, hallelujah. He's awesome.
Awesome.
He's awesome. If he's done anything for you, just say he's awesome.
Awesome.
My God.
My God is awesome.
He's an awesome God. Yeah. Hallelujah.
Awesome.
He's awesome.
Awesome. Awesome.
My God is awesome.
God is
Savior of the whole world.
Awesome.
giver of salvation. By his stripes I am healed. My God is awesome. Today I am forgiven. His grace is why I'm living. Come on, let's praise his holy name. Hallelujah. Oh God, my God is awesome. He's an awesome God. He's an awesome God. He's awesome. My God. Hallelujah. You're awesome, God.
Awesome.
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 Come on. I'll say that verse again.
Awesome.
My God is awesome.
My God
Savior
is
of the whole world. Giver of salvation. And by his stripes I'm healed. My God is awesome. Listen, today I'm forgiven. His grace is why I'm living. Praise his holy name. Come on, say, my God is awesome. Hallelujah. He's awesome. He's awesome. He's
awesome.
My God.
My God is awesome.
He's awesome.
Awesome.
He's awesome.
Awesome.
Come on, bro. Tell me a little bit.
Awesome.
Oh, he's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty.
God we serve.
Awesome.
Hallelujah. Come on, I'm gonna say, deliverer,
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 awesome.
He's awesome, he's awesome.
Awesome.
Hallelujah. He's mighty.
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 Awesome.
Awesome.
He's awesome. He's great.
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 Awesome.
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 He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
Awesome.
Awesome.
Awesome. I like that. I like that right there. He's holy.
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 Awesome.
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 God. Holy. He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
You're 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 holy. Awesome.
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 My God.
Yes, he is awesome. We can't let that go just yet. He's awesome this morning. You know, I was sitting there and I was thinking, this is the day that the Lord has made. I shall rejoice and be glad in it. Now, I know we've heard that a lot throughout our life. But I want you to take your sanctified imagination for a minute and think about it like this. This is the day that the Lord has made. Now think about if this was the day man had made. Think about that this week. It'd be a hot mess. Ooh, he's awesome.
He's awesome.
You know something else? When you go to talking about deliverance, see, if you ain't never been delivered from nothing, then that really has no meaning for you. But see, there was a time in my life when, like the old folks would say, I was on my way to a burning hell, a fast track to hell. But he thought enough about me that he delivered me from all the mess that I was entangled in. And I thank him for it. That's why I can stand here this morning and tell you, he's awesome.
He's awesome.
He's awesome. He's awesome. If you don't believe it, just give him a try. Come on, praise team. Yes,
he's awesome. Awesome. He's awesome. Awesome.
He's a deliverer.
Awesome. Deliverer.
Deliverer.
Deliverer. Deliverer. Deliverer.
Yes.
Awesome.
I don't care what it is. Nothing's too hard for God to deliver you from. If he can't do it, it can't be done.
Deliverer, deliverer.
He's awesome this morning.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Awesome.
Amen. 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 Thank God for Jesus. All right, I'm supposed to do the welcome. Actually, the welcome was given over 2,000 years ago. So what we do here is just a formality. But I'd like to ask all our visitors if you would please stand. Amen. Amen. I want to start on this side. State, remain standing, if you would. Young lady in the black right here, if you could give us your name and your church affiliation, if there be one. Amen. 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 And this young man right here.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. On behalf of our senior pastor, Elder E. Renee Collins, I just want to welcome you all to Kingdom Grace Fellowship Church, where?
Jesus Christ is King.
Amen. You're welcome. We're glad to have you here. And any way that you see fit to worship and praise your God, Have at it.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen. Just look at somebody and tell them God is awesome. Tell them he's awesome in this place. And he's awesome in me. All right, everybody stand to your feet. Come on, y'all know what time it is. Go and tell somebody you glad to see him today. Come on, not just somebody you rode to church with, but go to somebody you don't know. Hallelujah. God is good, ain't he? I know that's not good English, but sometimes you just have to say, ain't he? Look at somebody and say, God is good.
Ain't he?
Woo! It's not that we don't understand English. We know that what we're supposed to say is, isn't he? But sometimes he just been so good, you just have to say, ain't he? Amen, 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 amen. It is so good to see all of you all this morning. Amen. Bro, Mike, Minister Mike, you over there holding out. I threatened to whoop you, but you look bigger than me, so. But amen, we thank God for you. I am so glad my spiritual daughter and her fiance is in the house. I want them to stand again. Elder Christie and Bobby, amen. Bobby is actually Mike's cousin as well, so we just all in the family, amen. Amen, I thank God for them. Anybody else glad to see Brother Roosevelt today? Woo! Amen. We are so thankful that God has healed and sent him and his beautiful wife back to us, and she is back on her post, amen, doing what she do, amen. Ain't she looking good back there, amen, amen. And to all of you all, I tell y'all what, y'all's pastor's heart is still just full and overwhelmed, even over the Women's Day on last Sunday. Whew, what a time in the Lord. And then on yesterday, we had a class here. Pastor Richard Brown from Toledo came and taught on intercessory prayer. And I tell you,
amen,
it was just awesome. It's been a phenomenal, phenomenal weekend. Amen. We do have a presentation. Now, just so y'all know, I especially have to make sure Benita know, because she won't mind calling and telling me if I don't do right. So... But I do want you all to know that on Monday we surprised Sister Patty with a beautiful floral arrangement for all of her hard work and efforts, amen, for the Women's Day. But because this is a prophetic house, there was something that was laid on Prophetess Rhonda's heart to do as it relates to Prophetess Patty, so we're going to do that at this time. I'm going to ask Prophetess Rhonda, Sister Crystal, and Ashley, you're going to have to pinch hit for me today. So just, yes, you. Ain't nobody else saying name Ashley. This is actually our goddaughter. She has been with us since Thursday. Amen. Her parents are out of town, so she's been staying with us. And we just thank God for her. She has just been a delight. Amen. Amen. On yesterday, she works at a daycare. And so on yesterday, she took care of all of the babies so that the mothers could be in the teaching. Amen. All right. So I'm not sure. I'm just going to get to
you. Ladies, would you come up here? Crystal, come over here. Patty, I know you hate it, but if you would, just come up here with us, please. I need you guys on either side of her. You have to excuse and understand the prophetic office that I walk in. Everything is given to me, not everything, but much of what's given to me is given to me in a vision. And so as words are going forth, I see visions of the words coming together. Last weekend, we had an amazing, amazing Women's Day. It was awesome. And you don't have anything amazing without awesome leadership. And there's a lot of us that our badges and our titles and things are very visible. We're in the mic all the time, and we're doing something all the time that you see. And then there are others that work kind of behind the scenes that you don't see. And those leaders are just as important, sometimes more important even, than those of us who have the mic all the time. We've heard a lot lately about the quiet spirit that Patty carries. And she's called a lot of things, and God's put a lot of things in her. But Apostle Renee shared not too long ago that she has a mantle on her for a ministry for young women. And God heard that. And so as many things as I've heard since then, that would not let me go. Now, in the Bible, if you study it out, a mantle is a garment. It's a piece of clothing. It's also an assignment. And when God mantles you with something, it's not a choice anymore. When he places that mantle and he drops that mantle in your hand, it's not a choice anymore. And so regardless, Patty has no choice but to carry out what God has called her to do as a ministry to young women. We're going to have an amazing women's ministry in this house. Kingdom Grace is going to minister to lots of women. But there's a group specifically set aside that only Sister Patty is going to be able to minister to, because it's the mantle that God has given to her. And the reason that she's going to be able to effectively minister to them is because of what she's seen and what she's walked through herself and what she's been through herself and what she's watched young women who have her heart. This isn't just a thing. This isn't just something we decided to pick up. Her heart breaks. Her heart breaks before the Lord for young women. Her heart breaks and hungers to see what's in young women and the potential that's in young women come out. She's going to reach into their bellies, and she's going to pull the ministry out of them. She's going to pull liberty out of them. She's going to pull everything that God has in them out of them. And even you don't see it yet, Patty, the fullness of what God's going to do through you. But I promise you on my gift, God spoke it, that as these women lay this mantle over you, the weight of that ministry is going to be carried on your shoulders for this house. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Ladies, go ahead. Father, we thank you for this, your daughter, and this, your mother, to the young daughters that are coming to this house. We thank you for what you're going to birth in and through her. And we thank you, God, that she fully accepts her responsibility, and she'll go forth as the daughter of God and the mother to your daughters that you've called her to be. No lack, oh God. We stand behind her. We'll support her. We'll do whatever she needs in order to carry out the vision in Jesus' name.
Come on, I need you all to celebrate God for what he is doing. Hallelujah, in and through the life of Prophetess Patty. Amen. And I teach all of the time here at Kingdom Grace that just because an individual carried the same title does not mean that they flow in the same way. And so although we have several in the house that have been ordained, they didn't just pick up the title of prophet. They have been ordained as prophet. We are excited about what God is doing and how he's going to use her to reach young women. Amen. And I encourage, amen, I encourage the young women of our church to reach out to her. She's there for you. You can get her number. You can talk to her. Reach out to her. She is full of wisdom and ready to minister in this vein. Somebody just say, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, it is. It's a needed work because we have a lot of young ladies who are hurting. And one of the things, I'll say this again, one of the things that makes Kingdom Grace unique is that we won't just come in here and have church, but we're going to minister to the total needs of the people. Because it breaks God's heart for folks to come in church Sunday in, Sunday out, Sunday in, Sunday out, still hurting, still depressed, still confused. We serve a God, I'm going to talk about his blood in just a little bit, but we serve a God who has given us power. At Minister Ernest and the praise team, Minister Owens, boy, I tell you, when they hit that deliverance, how many of y'all know that we serve a God that can and will deliver? I need you to look at your neighbor and tell him you don't have to be in bondage. You don't have to be depressed. You don't have to be oppressed because we serve a God that will deliver. Hallelujah. So I am excited about what God is going to do in and through. Amen. And there's others. There's others in this house. I talk about Miss Ann. She also has a call to minister to young women, to women who are going through stuff and just don't understand and just need somebody to talk to that'll give them godly wisdom. Amen. And so I'm excited about what God is doing. Amen? Amen. Amen. Look at your neighbor and say, it's giving time.
It's giving time.
Come on, look at your neighbor and say, it's giving time. Amen. Amen. And we know that giving is a part of our worship service. As I mentioned on yesterday, I tell you, God is so faithful. We bought Pastor Brown here really with no budget. This wasn't a planned event. We didn't know how we was going to do it. We just know that God said do it. And so we brought him here, and early yesterday I was praying over how much to give him for coming. And I just wrote the check in faith. Now, we had it. You understand what I'm saying? I would never write anybody a check that we don't have. But so I wrote the check, and I said, okay, God, if this got to just come out of our general fund, so be it. But as God would have it, I'm trying to teach you right now on obeying God. As God would have it, he received an offering at the end of the class that not only took care of the check that I had written to him, but caused us to have a little bit of overflow. Look at somebody and say, that's how God do it. All right, now, are you talking about the okay, you're doing that now or later? Okay, so we're going to do our confession. Everybody got your offerings? Amen. Everybody got your envelopes? Amen. Amen. You ready? Because we understand our biblical responsibility as worshipers, we bring our hearts to God, recognizing that we return to him in our tithes and offering. Where our money is where our heart is. We pay the tithe because we owe God our vow. And we give our offerings, sowing seeds to reap fruit. We sow into our pastor to reap a prophet's reward. We sow into the church to reap kingdom benefits. As we cheerfully participate in giving and receiving, we have from the Lord jobs and better jobs, raises and bonuses, benefits, sales, and commissions, favorable settlements, estates and inheritances, rebates and returns, checks in the mail, gifts and surprises, bills paid off, and bills reduced, blessings and increase. I am out of debt. My needs are met. I've got plenty more to put in store. Thank you, Lord, for teaching me how to be a godly giver and receiver.
Amen. Along with your tithes and offerings, we know this morning is our love offering for our pastor. Amen. We know what we've been asked to do. We know the commitment that she makes. So we want to be able to sow into fertile ground, which is our pastor. Amen. So Sister Patty is holding the basket for pastor. You have your love offering envelopes, the one with the red heart. Please, 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 anything you can give. Amen. Amen.
All right. Amen. We do have an offering as well. From Mount Liberty of $25 towards yesterday. So we're going to put that in the general fund as well. All right, everybody turn. Everybody that's ready to give, turn towards the wall and come from the rear of your section. Hallelujah. All of the world will praise that great name. Hallelujah. 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 For his name is great, and he is greatly to be praised. Hallelujah. Can you just lift up your hands and say, Lord, I love you. Oh, God. Come on, does anybody really love him today? Are you just thankful to be saved today? Are you thankful for his great, great acts towards you? Are you thankful that we serve a God who is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think? The Bible says, according to the power that worketh in us. Those of you that have your Bibles, I just want to talk. I just want to talk today. I just want to talk today on this first Sunday. Because one of the things that struck me even on yesterday as we were in the session about intercessory prayer is this, that many of God's people live beneath the power that has been given to them. I'm going to say that again. Many of God's people. It's not that you don't love God, you do. It's not that you're not saved, you are. It's not that you don't love him, you do. But many of us are yet living beneath the power that has been given to us. And so today I just want to talk. I don't know that it's going to turn into a hooping message or not. But I just really want to talk to you out of this book of Romans. Now, those of you that come to Bible study know we've been in the book of Romans for several weeks, months. But I want to go to chapter 5 today, and I want to read verses 6 through 11. Because God wants us to walk in the power that he has given us. He doesn't want us to live defeated lives. He doesn't want us to allow the enemy to run roughshod over our lives. And so even on this first Sunday in this 11th month, we got one more month left in this year, and 2014 will be a wrap. And this morning, Sister Gwen, while I was making ready to come today, I heard the Lord say, I need you to remind my people that whatever their dream was on December 31st, whatever it was that you were believing God to do for you coming into this year, it's not too late. Delay does not mean deny. I need you to look at your neighbor and tell him it's not too late. In fact, we have entered into a season where things are being released into the hands of the people of God like never before. Sister Vicky, can I give your testimony? The first time I met her, I won't tell y'all, I won't go into detail.